Yes, hello, it's me again, Konrad from Racing Custom Parts. Today I will show you reinforcement for DQ500 and DQ250. Just like last time, rest of the movie will be in strange language for you. So please turn on the subtitles.
Let's begin. Okay, today I want to show you the installation of a reinforcement for the transfer case. For the transfer case to the DQ500 and DQ250 gearboxes. However, we'll focus on the DQ500 to avoid repeating videos. Why do we need the reinforcement? It's obvious. The force from the transfer case spreads the casing, which damages it in this way. This leads to the destruction of the casing, requiring replacement, causing unnecessary stress, as you can see in this video.
Cam așa de ușor e la curse. Simplu. Simplu.
This is one of the reasons why I designed the reinforcement for the DQ250, which in about 3 hours will be packed and on its way to Arad, in Romania, where it will be handed over to author of this video on Saturday. I hope this helps him, and that next week the car will be running as it should. But let's get to it. We're installing the reinforcement on the DQ500 transfer case, and like with the 02M, it's also made of 5mm bent steel, with the same principle of operation. The installation is also quite similar, though. I assume that if someone doesn't have an 02M, but rather a DQ500, they will be looking for the DQ500 video on our site. The first components are fastened together with the gearbox. I'll have to hold them somehow since I don't have a gearbox here. In your case, you'll bolt the gearbox in place, so the parts will be firm. The next component is this part of reinforcement. It goes on this side of the casing. You can catch it with a bolt for now. I'll also use a bolt here temporarily to keep that part from slipping away. There we go. And this part will keep slipping, so I'll just slide it in. That's the first step, attached to the gearbox. Mounted on this side here. We aren't screwing any bolts in yet. Oil is leaking. The gearbox was just opened, so it's no surprise there's oil. The second part to install goes on this side. Is it tight? Yes, it's tight because of the bolt I put here earlier. Once the bolt is removed, it's much easier. This bolt doesn't hold the reinforcement, but it has to be removed to install the part on the casing. Now we can start fastening the bolts. Like last time, these are prototypes. They're also new products on the site, and I'm installing and testing them while filming to show you how they look and fit. Maybe it will be useful to you. So, the transfer case is secured here, and it won't fall out now. It's loose for me, but for you, it shouldn't be. The difference between the 02M, E02Q, and DQ250's 500 is that, as I mentioned earlier, this part isn't welded on. This part is bolted. So, the reinforcement on the engine side doesn't require welding. I'm not installing all the bolts, I just want to show you how it works. For bolts here, here's the gearbox. Of course, the bolts will fit as well. It fits here. It fits there. I don't even have all the bolts for this transfer case. However, I'm showing that you'll be able to assemble everything. The final reinforcement for this transfer case is here, underneath, and it's also bolted. Obviously, onto this bolt. Oil might spill out soon, but oh well. It's bolted here. And here, from the back, with an M8 screw, which you will receive from me. Managed not to spill anything, so the whole reinforcement goes around like this. Its purpose is to hold the angular gearbox in place, simply reinforcing the housing, so the housing can keep the gears in position. If the gears stay in place, they'll work correctly and transfer much more power without damaging the gearbox, which means more fun for you. There's another detail, the engine mount. For the R32 engine, for VR6 engines, we also offer an adapter on our website. This mount is designed for this reinforcement. It's shorter here, so you can use it after installing our reinforcement. It's included in the kit, just like for the DQ250 gearbox. For which I also made, sorry, maybe you'll see better this way. For which I also made a mount for the R32 engine, it's also shifted by 10 mm, so the transfer case can be mounted in place. I don't have this for 02ME02Q yet, I'll probably make it, but I'll need the original part. I'll have to find one here in the warehouse, or just buy it and draw up a project, so it will be a complete kit like for DSG gearboxes. For the DQ250 gearbox, what more can I show? Installation is same as in DQ500 case, we mount pieces in same order as I just shown you. The reinforcement here is also bent and fastened, so it doesn't require welding. The bottom reinforcement, just like for the DQ500, is bolted. In this case, there are no bolts. Because we can't use the bolts on the gearbox due to differences in levels, height differences, so here, separate threads are made. These will hold the reinforcement. One reinforcement here, another one here. The gearbox will be reinforced just like the DQ500. That's exactly how it'll look. Obviously, I won't record this again, no need for that. What more can I say about this? As I mentioned earlier in the video, these reinforcements could be welded, but in case of welding, you should keep in mind that there will be a big problem with removing the transfer case from the transmission. So I'd be cautious with welding here. It would be better not to weld it. Otherwise, you won't be able to change the transfer case during a race, and nobody wants that, obviously. Okay, here's a quick look at the 3D model of how it fits on the R32 engine. And I'll say right away that I don't have knowledge of how it will fit on 1.8 turbo or 2.0 TFSI engines. I built this based on the VR6, the R32 engine, so that's what I can show you. As you can see, it's designed to fit perfectly. And for the DQ250, you can see the shift in the mount compared to the FactoryScan adapter. The same situation is true for the DQ500 gearbox. Here the mounting has also been redesigned to make space for the transfer case reinforcement. Likewise, the transfer case is reinforced in such a way that it doesn't interfere with the engine at all. However, it might interfere with the exhaust system. Since it sits a bit higher here as for the exhaust system. Unfortunately, that's beyond my control, and if it doesn't fit here, you'll have to make adjustments yourself. I can't do it any other way. I can't make it fit every exhaust system. As you know, exhaust systems for turbo engines are all custom-made, so there might be a risk of some issues here. I realize that no one watches these videos in full or listens to the instructions on how to assemble the housing, which most people can manage anyway. The purpose of these videos is to show the entire assembly so you can see where it's mounted, how it looks, and if you get a box of parts, you can visualize how those parts fit together. I'm not assuming you want to hear why you need this reinforcement or why your transfer case cracks. If your transfer case has cracked, you know exactly why it happened. If you're looking for this kind of solution, you surely know why you need it. As I mentioned, this video is mainly to visualize the details on the part to show how individual components fit together.
pojedynczych sztuk złożonych ze sobą. Także dziękuję
so,
raz jeszcze za
thanks again for watching. Even if you just skim through the video, I appreciate it. There will be a link to the part somewhere below the video, or somewhere on the side, I'm not sure yet. You'll find it anyway. The reinforcements are available on our website. So feel free to message us on Messenger, Facebook, WhatsApp or email, whichever is convenient for you. Best regards, and thanks.